Vsauce, Kevin here with two envelopes. One of them contains twice as much money as the other one, and you get to choose which one you want to take. But before you open your envelope and find out whether you've won the smaller prize or the larger prize, you have the opportunity to switch to the other envelope. So, do you? Do you switch? The answer is no. Irrefutably, 100% no. In our scenario, it makes absolutely no statistical difference which envelope you choose. Each one could contain the lower amount of money or the higher amount of money with equal probability, and you have zero information to help you choose one over the other. Right? Wrong! The answer is irrefutably 100% yes. Switch the envelopes, and there's a mathematical explanation for why. Right? Wrong! What is happening here? Let's start at the beginning. The origin of the two envelopes paradox is just as confusing as the problem itself. In 1953, Belgian mathematician Maurice Krejcik posed a scenario in his book about recreational mathematics in which two men compared the values of neckties their wives bought them, with neither man knowing the prices. Also in 1953, a math book credits a similar puzzle using playing cards to physicist Erwin Schrödinger. Ever hear of Schrödinger's cat? Where a cat in a box is both alive and dead until you open the box and find out? Yeah, same guy. And in our problem, the forces at play are the same whether we're using playing cards, neckties, or envelopes. Oh. Also, I'm wearing my brand new birthday paradox shirt. I have a floating space baby bracketed by the chart detailing the probability of at least two people sharing a birthday versus the number of people. It's in my new Vsauce 2 store, link below. Wear it for all the space children. So, look, the logic for not switching envelopes is pretty straightforward, given that you don't know anything about either one or even what the higher and lower values are inside them, one is just as good as the other. But the math in favor of switching is kind of compelling. Let's say that the envelope you choose contains X dollars. We don't know how much X is, just that there's something in the envelope we can call X. The probability of that envelope containing the smaller value is 1/2. And the probability of it containing the larger amount is 1/2, is 50%. The other envelope either contains twice that amount, 2X, or half that amount, 1/2X. If X turns out to be the higher value, then the other envelope contains 1/2X. If your envelope X is the lower value, then the other envelope contains 2X. Make sense? I've talked about expected value in a few other Vsauce 2 videos. It's the average of the possible outcomes of a series of probabilistic events, which we can use to identify the most advantageous course of action. So, to find the expected value of the envelope we didn't choose, we add the value of the only two possibilities weighted by their probability. Like this. 1 over 2 times 2x plus 1 over 2 times 1/2 x equals 5 over 4x. Half of the time the other envelope will contain 2x, and half of the time the other envelope will contain 1/2x, which equals an expected value of 5/4 x. 5/4 x is 25% more than just x, so our best possible choice is to switch to the other envelope. Cool, we did it. But that makes no sense! You have a simple, clean 50-50 chance of choosing the envelope with more money inside, and switching can't change that, but the math just told us that it can. Don't worry though. It gets weirder. What if I said you could switch envelopes again if you wanted to? Well, then you just go through the same process over and over again, always switching, never opening, forever and ever and ever, and erver and nerver and blurver. Those aren't words, but you get the point. Because switching makes the most mathematical sense, with switching gaining you a 25% advantage, and I just proved it. So... let's come back to math later. It's time for logic. Logician Raymond Smullyan posed two scenarios for the paradox. First, the risk of gaining twice the amount in your envelope is worthwhile when the alternative is only losing half of it. You're gaining X, or you're only losing half of X. The potential payoff is twice as high as your risk of loss. Makes perfect sense, but one envelope contains X and the other contains 2X. So you're either gaining X or losing X. Also makes sense, but both can't be true. So we're going to do this problem again using economics professor Barry Nailbuff's variation. Let's say that we give an envelope to player one and then flip a coin. If it's heads, we put double that amount in the second envelope and give it to player two. If it's tails, we put half that amount in the envelope and give it to player two. Neither player knows how much is in their envelope or the outcome of the coin toss. Once they open their envelopes in secret, they can switch with each other if they both agree to switching. Player one opens their envelope and finds 10 bucks. With equal probability, they think that switching to player two's envelope will get them 20 bucks for a $10 gain, or take them down to 5 bucks for a $5 loss. Player one decides to switch because switching gives them a greater possible reward relative to what they might lose. Player two, who's in another room, opens their envelope and finds 5 bucks. They think there's a 50% chance that switching to player one's envelope will get them 10 bucks for a $5 gain, or get them only $2.50 for a $2.50 loss. So player two also thinks that what they stand to gain is greater than what they might lose. They are absolutely sure that their upside is better than their downside. But it's obvious that both players can't have an advantage in this game. That's impossible. If you're confused at this point, good. Martin Gardner, one of history's greatest puzzle solvers and paradox explainers, knew the answer but admitted that there just wasn't a simple way to communicate the flaw in mathematical reasoning. And sadly, that's where our journey ends. No, it's not! Because we can figure this out. Think of it this way. The total sum of money in the envelopes is 3 units. A small unit and then a larger value that's made up of 2 smalls that combine to form a total of X. If you've got the smaller envelope, its value is X over 3. And if you have the larger envelope, its value is 2x over 3. When you switch from small to large, you gain x over 3. And when you switch from large to small, you lose x over 3. So the expected value of switching is 1/2 times 2x minus x over 3 plus 1/2 times x minus 2x over 3, which equals 0. There's just no value in switching. It doesn't help us and it doesn't hurt us, which is probably what you knew until we got math involved. The two envelopes problem is a lot more than just X and 2X, which is what makes it a falsidical paradox, because there appears to be a gain from switching when we fail to consider that the states of the two envelopes don't actually reflect simple values of X and 2X. A 2x envelope is only 2x when it's the larger amount, and the 1/2x envelope is only 1/2x when it's the smaller amount. Without recognizing that difference, basic algebra playing off our common sense fools us into thinking that each switch gives you a gain of 5 over 4 or 25%. It's really a matter of perspective. Depending on which envelope you're holding, which one you think you have, which one you think you don't have, and which one you want to wind up with, your course of action might be incredibly clear or not, and then clear again, and then not again. Until you realize that no matter if you diagnose it mathematically, no matter if you deconstruct it logically, no matter what you do, when it comes to the two-envelope paradox, you were right all along. And as always, thanks for watching.